Oh my god, ew. Oh my gosh. Okay, I don't think this lighting's gonna work. One second. Yeah, it's about hot as hell. And this lighting is not flattering. It's mainly just me, but look at my hair. Oh my god. I don't even have a tripod. Oh my gosh, y'all. Okay, it took like 10 minutes trying to. Oh my god, this is so ugly. Okay. Yeah, I took like 10 minutes just trying to find. Oh my god, ew. Okay, y'all. I don't know why I thought it was a good idea to film in the car. There's like a hell of people around. And I get really nervous, which is why I'm in my car, because I didn't want to film while my roommates were in the house, even though it's literally my cousin. Yeah. But okay, today I just wanted to make a video because I don't know, I just think it's fun editing it. I don't know why I like it. I just like to add the music. It's really like interesting tone. So I make a lot of videos just so I can use different songs like that I've been obsessed with. Yeah. Long time no see. And actually, since I did my last makeup video, it's been like 3 years. I think I've improved a little bit by then. I mean, today I'm just doing like a simple one because obviously I don't want to do full glam in the car. Like, I gotta get the eyeshadow and all this stuff. I've been breaking out a lot. Not sure what it's from. That's so not cute though. Okay, what do I usually start with? I don't know why I can't remember. Okay, I'm just gonna go with some winged liner. And there's so many different ways I do my winged liner. Like, I really change my entire makeup looks every single day because, I don't know, I just feel like sometimes it doesn't work. It depends on how I'm looking or feeling that day. No, if that makes sense. Like right now I'm feeling more of like a simple cat eye, I guess. Cause sometimes I can go real dramatic and bring it like up higher and then drag it all the way down to the front of my eyelid. But today I'm feeling just kind of simple. My face is still asymmetrical, so I have to like, you know, even it out manually. Yeah, that's good. And this really was a Q&A, but I asked last minute on Instagram like for some people to ask questions, so I doubt I have any, but you know what, let's go check. 1 second. Hey, we got questions. Okay, so I got 3. It's been like, okay, so I got 2 from one person, so shout out you for supporting. And one question was, what motivates you in the creative process? Oh shit. Okay, the first question was, what motivates you in the creative process when writing music? And that's a pretty good question. Okay, so usually I do contour first. I don't know why I forgot that, but okay, I'm gonna go back and do contour. But okay, back to the question. What motivates me the most in the creative process when writing music? Great question. So I really like to study music. Like, I really love music. I know everyone says that, but yeah, I really love music. Like, that's probably my number one passion, I guess you could say. I mean, I always make covers and everything, but okay, let me try to explain this better. And I like to study artists, you know? It's really subconsciously that I do it, but I always find myself like you know, interested in the beat process, like how did they make it, but how did they think of, you know, the lyrics that they wrote, like what's the story behind it. So I guess that kind of inspires me. I never have been good at writing though. So okay, so what I am good at when it comes to music and writing and, you know, creating my own type of sound, I'm pretty good at like making my own melodies, if that makes sense. Like if someone gives me a beat, like I can instantly think of like a melody to go with that, you know, like, you know, the rhythm, basically, like how they would sing it, not so much what they would sing. But yeah, I'm trying to get better at writing because I actually am trying to make some music. Just because, why not, you know? Like, I like music. Like, why not? Like, what would it hurt? Nothing. And I guess, like, when I wrote my one and only song that's, like, released, it's on SoundCloud, if you haven't heard it. It's nothing crazy. It was literally just because we were in quarantine and I was, like, bored. Yeah, when I was writing that song, really, I was just freestyling. Like, not in a rapping type of way, but that's one other thing I'm kind of good at, sort of. Like, I can think of things on the fly. It won't sound that good, but I can think of, like, quick, you know, a little something. Yeah, basically what I'm trying to say is when I wrote that song, I'm stuck in quarantine. It was just, you know, about, like, things that happened, like, right before quarantine and then during it. Like, in there, I'm like, I bought tickets for Nudie, tickets for Keisha, tickets for Edmund and Fuego, just for my baby, blah, blah, blah. I'm not even gonna do that because, what the fuck, no one knows this song. But yeah, I was just talking about how I bought all these concert tickets and like plane tickets to go travel, and then it all got canceled because of quarantine. And then I was talking about my crash, like my car crash, and I told my Mercedes, it's really my mom's. I'm so sorry, mom. Yeah, it was raining and I was speeding. I don't want to talk about it, but yeah, I've gotten in an accident. And then how about they made me go in the ambulance and charging me like $1,000 for nothing? They put one band-aid on my knee that was cut this much, and I was literally telling them, I was like, I'm fine, like, you know, I had a headache, but I was fine. I could have just Ubered home and went to sleep, like, not get charged $1,000 for them to put a band-aid on me. I mean, if you break a bone or if like something major happens, then yeah, of course go to the hospital, but less little things, chances are you can figure it out yourself. Like, you don't need to go and do that unless you got money. If you have a lot of money, then do what you do, it doesn't matter. But what I don't understand is the whole contouring thing. Like, you see how it still looks like muddy, like nothing, there's nothing contoured. I only do it so I can look tanner and to like kind of bring out my cheekbones. I don't know, but it doesn't really work. I don't think I'm doing it right. Let me know if you have any tips. Yeah, did I even answer I didn't even answer the question. But yeah, stay tuned if I start dropping some tunes, I don't know. We'll see what happens. Yeah, I'm just adding some blush. Every time I do a makeup tutorial, this shows why I shouldn't be doing it. And the second question I got was from the same person, Sad Boy Jones. Shout out you for giving me some questions to answer so I don't sit here having nothing to talk about. Before I get into the question, eyebrows are a really hard thing for me to do because I always either make it way too thick or just like not enough, you know what I mean? Like, sometimes they look really good, but it's really like if I'm really focused, like I have to really get into it. See, like that kind of looks good, but then I feel like I need more, right? I don't know. Just throw in something here. Okay. I keep turning the AC on and off because it gets hot, then it gets cold. back to the question. You said favorite anime. Okay, so I don't really watch anime. I know, kind of disappointing. I get it's the hype and everything, but I just have never gone into it, to be honest. Like, when I was little, sure, I would watch like Naruto and Dragon Ball Z, but really just because my cousin and my brother did. Like, I was never like, oh, put that shit on. No, it was just because they're watching it. And it was interesting. Like, I actually liked it. I liked the music, the soundtrack, and the way they animate. I mean, I guess I would say Dragon Ball Z only because that's the one I've watched the most. Like, I can remember some things from it. But let me know if there's some that I should get into. I think the reason why, I just don't watch TV in general. Like, I don't really watch TV. I don't know, it's because my attention span is like shorter now, or if I'm just not interested. The only TV series that I finished was Shameless, Parks and Recreation, The Office I almost finished, Family Guy. I really like funny shows. I'm debating if I should do fake lashes. Why not, right? Yeah, let's do fake lashes. Okay. Yeah, we have one more question. So far, for my dear mutual, the Planet Wolf, shout out to him because he supported my art, you know, my animations, and, you know, commissioned me to do a couple of cool pieces for him. But you can check it out on my Instagram. Lauren Sangaphone, but the L is a 1 and the S is a 5, so it's like 1 or in 5 Angaphone. But yeah, shout out him for supporting me. Anyway, he said, when did you realize you were a future GOAT? And that's funny. So I mean, I hope I am. You know, I'm always still learning and always trying to progress, but hopefully something comes out of it, you know. But yeah, I mean, I guess I realized since I was born, you know, I was like, oh, there's a lady walking her dog looking at me. But yeah, I guess the correct answer would be 2019, I guess. Like, that's when I really started getting confident and working on a lot of different projects, just because I knew I could, you know? And that's not on any cocky shit. Like, anyone can do anything they put their mind to, as long as they want to do it, you know? Because we're in an age where we have all of this information, like, literally in the palm of our hands. Like, on your cell phone, you can look up anything, like how to sew, how to make animations, how to draw, how to play guitar. All the things I know how to do, like, well, most of them, I learned from the internet. You know, you don't need, like, I don't know. I'm not gonna say you don't need school, but you don't need school to achieve the things that you want to achieve. You can even get a business degree on, like, you know, online. Oh my gosh, what did I do to my... Just trying to contour this a little bit. Oh my gosh. But really, guys, like, I see a lot of people that always say, I want to learn how to do this, I want to learn how to do that. And it's like, do it. Like, you act like you can't. It's a little harsh, but, you know, it's just like, you have all of these opportunities. I mean, I get it. Some people don't have time or, you know, they're not able to invest in the things that they want to do. Like, they can't go out and buy a guitar right now or go out and buy a laptop to start doing certain things. But if you push yourself, like, you know, one day you'll be able to get it. You have to believe in yourself for real. And I'm saying this because, you know, like, I've been through it. Like, I don't be having all this money. Like, I just save up and get the things that I want to get. Sometimes I go a little too ham and too excited and buy all these random things that I just don't need. I'm trying to see if this lash fits. That's too big. But you know, it comes in handy, like, eventually. And at the end of the day, I made myself happy and I bought, you know, something I always wanted. So, yeah, that's all I'm saying. Just put your mind to it, put your grind to it, and get it done. Long story short, is that 2019 was probably when I realized my potential. So I'm gonna say it. Or realized I was a future goat. And you all can be too. Yeah, I really am proud though, because my confidence has gone a long, long way. Like, if I wanted a house, I could go get myself a house. It would take some time, like a lot of time and saving, but I could do it. Period. Okay. This eyelash is like falling off in the corner. It's falling off. Makeup is a talent. I don't care what anyone says. It is a talent. Like, this shit is hard. Okay, I think that's pretty good. Not gonna lie. Right? It's just kind of like falling off in the corner. But the corner is not sticking though. Okay. From my point of view, I have pretty bad eyesight. It looks okay. So I'm just gonna let it be. I'm just gonna do my lips. Some perfume for no reason. Just smells good. And guys, I got this. I don't need it right now because it just did my makeup, but later when it gets like oily, it's the Revlon like rollerball applicator thing, and you just like, it's volcanic rock, which is super absorbent, you know, naturally. So it kind of takes away all the oils, you know, if you get like glowy or whatever. I don't know, I found that it helped for me, so just throwing it out there. No more questions. It's kind of sad. Thought y'all wouldn't fuck with me more than that, but whatever. You ain't got a lie. You ain't got a try, so. I know a lot of people, like, I've been into lip liners lately. So, the one that I use is just kind of the color of my lip. See? This is Nude Truffle. And I just lightly outline my lips, like, on the top. I don't know if you saw, I just go over the edges. And here, you know, I have small cupid's bow, so. And here, I just like. And I don't like to fill it in, just because I'm really a chapstick person. Like, I don't really like using lipsticks or anything like that. I kind of wipe it off throughout the day, so I just like outline the outer part of my lips, and then I'm putting some lip balm, some Aquaphor, and yeah, it's like shiny, you know. Even lip gloss doesn't really work for me because, like I said, I rub it off. Okay, let's check on these eyelashes. I can't tell if it looks good or not. Oh my god. Okay, y'all, this is the finished look. I don't know if you can really see anything. This lash is not working with me, so clearly lashes are not my strong suit. Yeah, but this is the final look. I kind of feel like I should have done more with my eyebrows. But yeah, this is the best that we got for now. Thank you for those three questions, y'all. Shout out to you. Yeah, I wish you made this more entertaining. I don't really know what I was supposed to say. Yeah.